and welcome to the daily newspaper and blog headline update. Today, the 1st of February, is the Nkwo Market Day in the Igbo cultural calendar. I am Akalonu Michelle. Now, we'll look at the punch headlines for today. DSS wants to arrest me, CUPP spokesman alleges. Foundation offers scholarships to winners of spelling competition. Design Junior portfolio size hits $600 million. Airtel promotes giving culture with ATL initiative. Guinness inaugurates agri scheme to support local content. Maafa asks Buhari to shelve Zamfara rally and hails INEC. Indomie introduces new variant to Abuja consumers. Lawmakers move to ensure completion of CBN's projects. Now from the Vanguard newspaper. Concerning the elections, NYSC calls for security of core members. CCT fixes February 4th to resume the trial of suspected CJN Onoyen. Oyo monarchs and stakeholders are behind Adebayo Adelab, says Ajimobi. Fire got scandal market and building in Sabongari. Urobo youths threaten to withdraw support for Buhari over the FUPRE Act. Iwobi and Ndidi to preview Super Eagles' latest jersey in a forthcoming ceremony in London. Governor Akeredolu of Ondo State lays foundation of Advanced Technology Center in Okitipupa. Now we'll look at the nation's newspaper. INEC claims Sanwo-Olu, Kashamu, Oga and others. Buhari in Kano. I will continue to fulfill my promises. Concerning the presidency, time to change Nigeria is now, says Soyinka. Presidency, time to change Nigeria is now, says Soyinka. Magu warns bankers on politicians repatriating stolen funds. There is an article on why restructuring is key to unity by Akinrinade. There is also one on why Atiku should sue Obasanjo by Oshomole. How to save the judiciary by democratic lawyers. Now we'll take the news from pmnewsnigeria.com. INEC releases final list of candidates for state elections. Civil society groups threaten showdown with Lagos Assembly. CCT resumes Onoyen's trial on February 4th. I never said I'll fight to divide Nigeria if Buhari rigged to win, says Obasanjo. Buhari and Atiku are not the solution. We need alternatives, says Soyinka, Falana, and Abori Shade. Hoodlums attack PDP Abaje's convoy in Lagos. Thank you very much for listening, and now we have come to the end of today's news headlines. Join us again tomorrow. I am Akalonu Michelle. Good day.